Hello, everybody. Got some new news for everybody, some new movie news. So we have a new Scream movie in development. Right now it's called a reboot. We haven't we, that's the only information we have for this one is it's going to be directed by the same directors that did Ready or Not, which I thought that movie was I know I might get some crap about this, but I thought it was just okay. Had the weirdest twist I've ever seen in my life. I did not expect that twist. It's probably something I'm not gonna watch again. But they're gonna be directing the Scream movie, and also they're gonna bring Kevin Williamson back. Thank God. Well, my thoughts about this is I really am kind of hoping instead of a reboot, because like I said before in my other video, I'm tired, so tired of these reboots. I really am hoping. Cause I really love this is I love this. This is my favorite 90s slasher series, my favorite horror slasher series of the 90s. I really love this series. I think I watch this series almost every year. I love the character of Ned Campbell's character, Sidney Prescott, like Gale Weathers, played by Courtney Cox. She's just such a witch on that movie, but her character she was likable, even though she was horrible person at first. We also got Dewey, played by David Arquette. I would like to see him back. I don't know. That'll be kind of awkward between him and Courtney Cox because they're not married no more. I don't know if that was a bitter divorce, but that would be a little awkward if they're cordial with each other. They can bring them back. I would love to see their characters back. Because you know what happened in the last movie. We found out that Sidney Prescott's cousin was a killer. It was played by Emma Roberts, Julia Roberts' niece, Eric Roberts' daughter. We found that she was the killer, and also what was his name? I can't remember his name. But he's one of the Culkin brothers. He was the second killer. Technically, it was Stu and what's the boyfriend? And doggone it. Sorry guys, I can't remember the boyfriend's name. Stu and oh man, I'm sorry guys. I can't remember. I got a brain lock right now. But you know, the two killers from the previous movie, the first movie. So that was technically it was te Scream 4 was kind of, I guess you could say, kind of a teeny remake, because it's back in Woodsboro again, and where back in where she lived, because the other movies was out of Woodsboro, but this one was back in Woodsboro. She goes back. Because she wrote a book about her life, well, everything that happened in her past. She wrote a book about it, so she came back to Woodsboro to promote her book. So we know what happens in that. It's kind of like it was like a teeny bit of a pseudo remake, kind of. But I mean, I think that the reviews were divided about it too. I really enjoyed part four. I mean, I even enjoyed part three. I know part three is kind of my least favorite, but I have really enjoyed. I know a lot of people think that's the worst in the series, but I like all four movies. I really enjoy all four movies. So I'm kind of really am hoping. I'm really hoping it's not a reboot. I'm kind of hoping this is actually a continuation. And maybe it can do some new twist to it some kind of way. I don't know what else these directors have done. I don't think they did Ready or Not. I think that's the only thing they've done, I think. I haven't did my homework and study and, trying to find, find out, see what else they directed. I didn't do none of that. I should have did that, but I didn't do my research, so I just read a little. I'm gonna put the link on the bottom also about that, about the in development. So I'm kind of anxious to see what they do with this. I still hope they use the Ghostface mask and in the suit and everything. I kind of hope they use the same costume they did, and I hope they bring the voice actor back that did disguise his voices. What's your favorite movie, Sydney? Stuff like that. I like that guy. I can't remember his name. I wish I did. I should have did my research before I did this video. But I really hope they bring that back. And if they're gonna reboot, please keep it the same formula. Don't. I'm so tired of them changing stuff. If you want to do a reboot, do it right. But I really am hoping this is actually a continuation, and he can bring Neve Campbell back. I know at first he kept saying it was gonna be Scream 5, but now he has this new information about this could be a reboot. But I really have my fingers crossed, hoping that this is actually a continuation slash reboot, like they're doing with the Halloween movies. But I'm hoping they don't go that route. I don't want them to do an exact you know, a direct sequel to the first movie. I don't want them to do that. I don't want them to ignore 2, 3, and 4 because I really love 2. 3 is my least favorite, but I really like it. I like part 3, and I really enjoy part 4 also. So I'm hoping if this actually if they're gonna bring Neve Campbell back, if it's a continuation, don't do like they do, you know, like doing with Halloween and the Terminator movies. And like they did with Predator. Don't do a direct sequel to the first movie. I want to actually do a continuation to part 4. So that's what I'm hoping they do with this. So I don't know how they would do it if they do bring Neve Campbell back. What would be the twist? What else can you do? I don't know what else you can do with it. I know some people, I heard people say that I've read someone they should make Neve Campbell the new killer. I don't think that's a good idea. They really like make Jamie Curtis working with Michael Myers or something. It's kind of silly to me. I don't think I would want that. But we'll see what they do. Like I said, I didn't hate Ready or Not. I'm probably not gonna watch it again though, because it was so bizarre then. I'm like, okay. I liked it up until that part, but the reveal part really got to me. I didn't really care about the reveal part. It was kind of just out there to me. That's to me. But I didn't hate the movie. This is rest in peace. I really do wish Wes Craven was alive and he could do something with this, but we'll see what what these people can do, this director can do. So we'll see. I'm just glad he got Kevin Williamson back on as a writing person so that he can write and produce it, hopefully, and maybe he can give them pointers on what they can do with this one. But I'm anxious to see what they do. I just really am hoping it's not a just all-out reboot. I'm hoping that they can do more. You know, like I said with the Halloween, do it like that. Bring Neve Campbell back, but don't make her. She could be like kind of maybe the minor character, maybe, and he could be like a new survivor, and she just helps her out, maybe. You know, something like that. Not like they did with Halloween. Instead of really focusing all on Laurie Strode, they also had her granddaughter. And her daughter and everything, and her husband and everything. So they can do something like that, maybe. I'm not saying she should have like a kid on there. It kind of would make any sense because that the part 4 came out like what 20? When did part 4 come out? 2012, I think, is when part 4 came out. I think or 2011. So that would make any sense to have a little kid. That means it would be a little kid. But I don't know, guys. I don't know what they can do with it, but. We'll see. We'll see what they do with it. I don't know when they plan on doing the casting. They're just talking about that's in development, so we don't know when it's going to be released. Sometime in the future, we don't know. But like I said before, I'm kind of hoping it's a sequel instead of a reboot, and some kind of way they can bring Neve Campbell back. And I hope, please, please, I hope that if they do bring this back, give it some kind of crazy twist. I really am I'm really am hoping we get a good twist with this also, and some good decent suspense like they did with the previous movie. So we'll see. We'll see, guys. Still not happy about I still haven't changed my mind about Saw. Because at least with Scream, to me it didn't get worse. Saw series got worse to me. I think after maybe 4, that's when it started going downhill. And that Jigsaw movie was just pathetic. It sucked. It was horrible, and that's why I got so on the Spiral movie with Chris Rock in it. You know, I mean, it could be good, but it just don't. It's not wheeling me in. It's not getting my attention. It's not exciting me. That's like kind of like I think that's a continuation slash reboot kind of. But Scream is a better series than that, in my opinion. So. Well, guys, that was my little thoughts about the new Scream movie. I'm really hoping this is going to be good. Hope they do something good with this movie. And I'm really have my fingers crossed hoping that they bring Neve Campbell back some kind of way and they can bring Dewey and Gale back. I really am hoping they can bring them back some kind of way and have this great movie. I'll be there, definitely. I've seen the third and fourth one in theaters. I have never seen 1 and 2 because I wasn't old enough to see those yet. I was still a kid. I didn't get to see rated R movies until I was 16 years old, so. We'll see what they do in the future. We'll see. See what the casting is going to be and everything. So, and I hope it's a good lead. So, instead if it's not, if it's not a Sidney Prescott, they give us a decent lead and give us a good actor that can actually act in these movies. So, we'll see, guys. That was just my little quick thoughts about what I think about this new Scream movie and what I would like to see in it. Hope you guys enjoyed. Hit that thumbs up. Hit that notification bell. And hit the subscribe button. I really would appreciate it. And guys, I hope you enjoy the rest of your Friday night. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.